Good evening and welcome to the Churchill High School first ever virtual winter choir concert. I am Jacob Steinberger and I'm the director of choirs here at Churchill. And I am so excited, as the students are, so excited to have you guys here joining us. We have quite the show for you this evening. A little background though first. When we entered into online learning this fall, a lot of teachers across the country and the world were trying to figure out how in the heck do we teach our subject over Zoom and online entirely. Now, I believe it's been done with many subjects before, and so there's been a little bit of precedence there and maybe some previous ideas on how to do that. But I'm not sure that choir has ever been done like that before. So, or band and any performance classes like that. So we kind of, as music teachers, we're all kind of scrambling a little bit going, well, we need to make this work for the students, but how are we gonna do it? And so with a lot of planning and collaborating with colleagues, we kind of came up with this model of rehearsing online and just trying to make it as much like choir as we possibly could, despite our circumstances. And so, what does choir class look like? Those of you parents that have been home with your students, you've kind of got a bird's eye view of that. But for those of you who haven't seen it, we basically get on, we say hello to each other, we talk, we check in, we connect with each other, and then we start warm-ups. And the teacher, myself, I'm on piano, and we do all of our warm-ups, and the students are there in their rooms or their houses singing along with just me and my piano, and they can't hear any of the rest of the singers at all because of latency issues with Zoom. And so they're singing by themselves, they're vulnerable, and they are distant from people. What I am proud, though, to say is that we have found a way, and obviously that is why we're here tonight with this virtual concert. We found a way to overcome our circumstances and not fall victim to them, and we have rehearsed our music, we have connected with each other, we have talked about the music, we have made connections to the music and to our fellow classmates and singers, and I really think that the perseverance, once we kind of got over that initial hump of kind of the shock of online choir, the students have really, really pulled through, and I've been just increasingly impressed by them as the term rolled on. And so we decided to put on this concert to showcase the many, many efforts and all the hard work that people have put into it. And so here we are. So a couple of statistics and facts about this fall. So in the last 12 weeks, we have 3 choirs. We have had 72 rehearsals collectively. We have had which means 7,920 minutes of rehearsal time. And we have had 60 hours of audio editing with no auto-tuning, approximately 30 hours of video editing, 1 failed recording program, 1 successful recording program, yay Soundtrap, and finally, 1,367,252 utterings of "You're muted, Mr. Steinberger." Yes, that is the struggle of online learning. All right, so alongside with the hard work of the students, there are some very important people that were just so instrumental and dedicated their time and efforts to making this happen for our program. And I want to make sure and just go down the list here and thank each one of them before we get our program started. So first and foremost, Vivian Tritch. She is a senior at Churchill. She sings in the Downing Street Singers and Concert Choir. And Vivian has donated her talents and time towards editing all of the video for the performance that you're about to see. She got accepted into Chapman University to study film. She's also, so yay, Vivian, that's so awesome. Which is her dream come true. She's also helped along the last couple years with making some really cool parody choir commercials to help kind of advertise for choir and recruit for us. So thank you so much, Vivian. This literally would not have happened without you. I could not have done it. The next on the list is the fantastic Bruce, Jennifer, and Jessica Searle. They are responsible for helping make some of the part tracks that students got to sing along to, accompaniment, and helped with some lighting. Next person is an alumni, Ryan Dallimore. You'll hear him playing drums with our Downing Street Singers. Thank you, Ryan. Next is a sophomore, current sophomore, Eden Steffen, for the creation of the concert poster and the social media posts that you have seen. Next, I would like to thank my dogs, Arlo and Marv, for putting up with me singing and making weird noises all day to a computer screen. Thank you so much, you guys. Next is our Churchill administration. Thank you for your continuous support and advocacy of the importance of music education for these students. We appreciate it so much. And a couple more here. I would like to thank also my band colleague, Chris Mudd, and all of my other colleagues across the state for the wonderful work that they are doing, which is the very work that we've been doing. And there are a lot of people doing it and doing amazing things. So we appreciate you. And lastly, our choir council and student MCs for your resiliency, your humor, and heart that you put into the creation of this concert. Thank you so much. Well, I hope you enjoy the show, and I will now turn it over to our student MCs coming to us from Zoom, of course. Take it away.
Hi, I'm Rowan. I'm a senior this year. I sing soprano in Downing Street Singers, and I am the soprano section leader in concert choir.
I'm Stephanie. I'm a senior this year. I am a soprano in the Downing Street Singers and one of the alto section leaders in concert choir.
Hi, I'm Rogan. I am a senior this year. I sing tenor in the Downing Street Singers, and I am the tenor section leader as well as the president in our concert choir. For our first song of the evening, our concert choir is presenting you a song that we were given on early in the year, and we really thought that it just kind of encapsulated our desire to sing despite the circumstances of everything. This song is called How Can I Keep From Singing, and the title is kind of a giveaway to our meaning behind it. We just really wanted to show that we were dedicated to this, and it was just a way to prove to ourselves, and we hope that you enjoy it.
I hear the sweet, though far.
Wow, that was such an amazing piece from Concert Choir. Great job, you guys.
Yeah, that was awesome. That makes me think about the beginning of the year when we were just getting started with all this stuff, and it was kind of hard. But now that I think about it, we really started to see the light.
You know, Steph, it's funny you say that, because this year, as our Downing Street Singers, we're trying to learn how to sing jazz from home and how to mesh as a group when we're so far away from each other. We actually managed to record this sweet little swing piece that's called I'm Beginning to See the Light.
Song. Great job on the scat, Abby. Next, we have our first holiday tune, and Rogan will tell you a little bit about that.
Yeah, so this tune is going to be sung by our very own Dakota Harris, and he wrote a little blurb for us all to help you kind of understand why he's singing this and what it means to him, so I'm going to read that out for you. Dakota says, "This song you have heard every year, maybe all year." He says, "This song reminds me of when days are really nice, even when it was cold. It still fills me with warmth, and this song brings back all the good memories and times I've had in the past, even when it snows. But there's always one thing that always stays with me when it's cold outside, or even when everything is sad and blue, which is the magic of family, love, and even if it doesn't snow, a white Christmas." So everybody, this is Dakota Harris performing White Christmas for all of you. Enjoy.
The white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, in the snow, where the treetops listen and children listen to you, the sleigh bells in the snow. I dream white Christmas. With every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright.
That was so cool, Dakota. That was so awesome to see pictures of your family. Rowan, what do we have up next?
Next up, we have a piece from our very own treble choir called Cantamos. And members of treble choir have written a few things and their feelings about the song. And so we're going to read a few of those too. From one of the members, Cantamos is a song about uniting and singing together. Even if we are not together in the same room, the song can bring us a little closer. I've never done choir before, and so I was not sure what to expect, but choir so far has been so much fun. I'm glad even though we technically can't sing together, we can still come together in some way and sing. I hope this song brings a little warmth into your heart.
And then another member said, Cantamos' lyrics are fairly basic, but I feel like they summarize our feelings about choir this year quite well. This was my first year in choir, and I know it was the same for several others. We all signed up for this feeling hopeful for the next year, but soon enough, the pandemic hit. And yet, through having a sense of community and with the help of Mr. Steinberger, we've managed to have what I think is a decently fun and hopeful introduction to a performance. And despite our small class size, we put in the effort to put together our first real project, a performance portraying our young, exciting, and simple love of group singing.
We sing.
Song is one of the Downing Street Singers' favorite songs from last year. Normally, the Downing Street Singers like to travel around to different places in Eugene and sing our holiday set list. Obviously, this year we can't do that, but this song just really reminds me of singing with some of my closest friends in this awesome group, and so we were lucky enough for a few singers from our school to choose this song to still sing virtually. So this is That's Christmas to Me.
The fireplace is burning bright, shining all on me. I see the presents underneath the good old Christmas tree. And I wait all night till Santa comes to wake me from my dreams. Oh, why is that Christmas to me? I see the children play outside like angels in the snow. Mom and Daddy share a kiss under the mistletoe. And we'll cherish all these simple things wherever we may be. Oh, why is that Christmas to me? I've got this Christmas song in my song in my heart. I've got the candles glowing in the dark. Oh, I'm hanging all the stockings by the Christmas tree. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me.
Listen for the thud of reindeer walking on the roof as I fall asleep to lullabies. The morning's coming soon.
The only gift I'll ever need. Joy of family, oh why, 'cause that's Christmas to me.
As warm as my heart to hear myself singing alongside of some of my friends and carrying this just powerful universal message of holiday times and family. It's really important to me, and I hope you guys enjoyed that. Last spring, we lost someone who was very special to our school and especially our choirs. The next song was written, composed, choreographed, and performed by sophomores Emily Ashton and Selena Prince. This next song is in honor and remembrance of our dear friend, Sarah Jensen, and her beautiful soul.
She had a contagious smile, fiery red hair, and numerous freckles that came out in summer, a gorgeous voice, bright blue eyes, always genuine and honest, and had the best laugh. But overall, was a beautiful soul. We had the best memories of dancing and staying up laughing until we couldn't breathe, taking pictures and failing tests, singing Carrie Underwood as loud as we could, and I loved her beautiful soul. She was the light in all the darkness. She was the love within so much hate. She cared for me when I felt worthless. She was an angel who glowed so bright. And we all miss her beautiful soul. Beautiful soul, beautiful soul, beautiful soul, beautiful soul, beautiful.
When asked why they loved soul, and missed Sarah, people responded with these things: her smile, the way she made everyone's day. I remember walking down the halls and she would find anything she could to compliment me. She always asked how my day was in choir. Sarah was there for me when I wasn't there for myself. She was so sweet and had us both always laughing in class together. She was truly a blessing. She looked like a model even with wind in her hair and sand in her clothes. She taught me how to tie a balloon. She never made me feel like I had to become someone I wasn't just to be friends with her. She was an amazing friend, and I'm forever grateful that she was part of my life.
She was the light in all the darkness. She was the love within so much hate. She cared for me when I felt worthless. She was an angel who glowed so bright. And we all miss her beautiful soul.
Thank you.
Mr. S, you're muted. Every single day, this happens.
Okay, there we go. Sorry about that. Like I said, it happens a lot. Welcome back from intermission. We hope that you had a good little 5-minute break to reset. And I would also like to applaud and say thank you to Emily and Selena for that beautiful tribute to Sarah Jensen. Her beautiful soul lives on in the hearts and memories of so many of our students. Thank you, guys. Music has a way of reaching people and accessing every single human emotion. As performers, we are constantly tapping into that wide array of human experiences so that we can activate and hopefully inspire our audiences to empathize and feel those emotions with those of us on stage. Our next performer is certainly no exception to this artistic process. He writes, "Right before the pandemic started, I was in Maui with my girlfriend and was having a blast. When we got back home, I wrote a song about her and was going to surprise her on her birthday. Then she dumped me before I had the chance. After some time to myself, I rewrote the song to express whatever bottled up emotions I had left and channeled my feelings into a song I think a lot of people can relate to. I hope you enjoy. So here is Marco Pena performing his original song, Paradise.
But feel like I'm soaring. When you were around, the life could never be boring. Fill my heart with glee without even knowing. Couldn't we just vibe in the paradise that we were in? In the paradise we were in. Just vibing the paradise that we were in. In the paradise we were in. In the paradise we were in. In the paradise we were in. It's inevitable that we all fall. It'll always hurt no matter how big or small. And although it'll hurt no matter what I do, in the end it's just what's best for me and you. Sunrise shines, horizon is glowing. I don't know what to do, I don't know where we are going. Let your mind find the beauty that's growing. Embrace the grace of the paradise that you're in. By your side, couldn't help but feel like I'm soaring. When you were around, the life could never be boring. Filled my heart with glee without even knowing. Couldn't we just vibe in the paradise that we were in? We were in. In the paradise we were in. Just wanna go back to the paradise that we were in.
Wow, I really enjoyed that piece. That was such a good way to bring us back from intermission. Next up, we have a piece by two of our choir students whose piece really demonstrates what we were able to do with our recording program Soundtrap. All of the instruments in the next piece are virtual instruments, meaning that they weren't live recorded and they are from the program itself. And the performers wanted me to let you know that 2 years ago, they were both in a production of Elf the Musical put on by Upstart Crow Studios. Abby played Jovi and Riley played Buddy. They were inspired by the iconic bathroom scene from the movie and have been waiting for an opportunity to sing this classic duet together. So next up, we have Riley and Abby singing Baby It's Cold Outside.
I've gotta go
but
away.
I can call you a ride.
Oh, this evening
I'm
has
so
been
glad that you
so very
in.
Nice.
Time spent with you is paradise.
My mother will start to worry.
I'll call the car and tell him to hurry.
My father will be pacing the floor.
Wait, what are you still living home
So really
for?
I'd better scurry.
Your driver, his name is Murray.
But maybe just a half a show.
Oh, we're stuck inside, so who's
oh,
keeping
score? Will my friends think,
I think that they should rejoice
if we hang out
it's
this
your
week.
Friends and it's your choice.
Oh, you really know
your eyes
how
are like stars
to cast
now.
A spell.
One look at you and then I feel
I ought to say no, no,
then you
no,
really
sir.
Ought to go, go,
at
go.
Least I'm gonna say that
well,
I tried.
Larry, he just pulled
oh,
up outside.
I really can't
stay. I understand, baby.
But it's cold outside. To say no,
I guess that's respectable.
Oh, this welcome has
I feel
been
lucky that you
so nice
in.
And warm.
But you better go before it's
my
storms.
Sister will be suspicious.
But gosh, this food looks delicious.
My brother will be there at the
oh,
door.
He loves my music, baby. I'm
my
sure.
Gossipy neighbor's
I'm
vicious.
A genie, tell me what you're
but
wishing.
But maybe just another song.
Oh,
more.
Let me lead you to the
oh,
dance.
Oh, I've got
floor.
To get home.
Baby, I'm well aware.
Say, lend me your
oh,
cup.
Oh, keep it, girl, I don't care.
Oh, you've really
I
been
feel
grand,
good when you touch
but
my
don't
head.
You see?
I want you to stay, but it's not up to me.
There's bound to be talk
well,
tomorrow.
They can talk, but what do they know?
At least there will be plenty
oh,
of time.
Oh, I'll let them mind their business and go.
Baby, just go. It's cold, baby. It's cold.
It's a Churchill Choir tradition to sing O Holy Night every year at the winter concert. This year, a group of seniors was able to record this and sing this special song one last time. It's also a tradition for our Churchill alumni to stand up and sing with us. No, really, stand up. Okay, come on, people that are next to them, tell them to stand up.
And this year, after every year of choosing a soloist to perform at the concert, we are lucky to have our very own Stephanie Sterling performing as our soloist. Please enjoy.
Ooh. it's worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious
piece. I'm so grateful that we were all still able to record and perform this tradition, even in socially distanced choir. Right now, we wanted to pause for a second and give thanks to all the people who helped make this concert possible. One of those people is one of our very own students, Vivian Tritch, who has spent countless hours video editing this concert to make it possible and share it with all of you. We are so excited for her because she has been accepted into her dream film school and will be off next year studying film production. And we are so excited and grateful for her.
Another one of these thanks belongs to, in most things, but especially for this concert, our dear director, Mr. S himself. He has spent countless hours, countless energy, just all of his time poured into all of the choirs that he does. From the beginning of this year up until now, making sure to work as hard as possible to make sure that we all feel as if we're still part of a choir, even though we're apart. And he's probably wearing Birkenstocks as it's a concert day and his dogs are nearby. And we're just so thankful for him, everything that he does. And we couldn't ever ask for a better director. So thank you, Mr. S. And finally, for our last song of this concert, our concert choir would like to share with you the fruit of their labor from the past few weeks, recorded individually and brought together for this performance. This song is titled, We Will Rise Up Together, and its message is one of hope, of unity, and of perseverance, which is exactly what was required to create this whole concert and share it with you today. This year has been nothing but trial after trial, and we've all lost something, but we hope to bring you the same sense of hope, the same sense of unity, and the same sense of perseverance that this choir has maintained, even as we stay distant from one another. We urge you, listen to the lyrics and reflect on how this year has brought us all together, despite how far we are apart.
I keep on moving and now
Yay, concert choir! Oh my gosh, I love that song so much, and you guys sound so good on it. What a great way to close the concert tonight. And congratulations to all of the singers that did such a fantastic job on this performance. I'm so proud of you guys and can't wait for trimester two to work with you. For the audience, it is at this point in the night that I usually thank you all for coming and wish for you to drive home safely, but I think that one of those has definitely already been taken care of. And so it is with a grateful heart that I say on behalf of myself, the Churchill High School staff, and our spectacular singers in the choir department, thank you. Thank you for supporting these young people and taking the time to tune into their virtual performance. We all wish you a safe and happy winter break and holiday season. Good night.